So, in case you haven't noticed, YouTube, in their unmatched wisdom, has decided to remove the dislike counter from all videos. In other words, the only way you can now tell whether a video is approved by others or not is by reading a bunch of comments or looking at the amount of likes on the said video. Now, this might not matter that much for some YouTubers and some videos, but the thing about my channel is that it's mostly composed of tutorial videos. The exact type of video where someone wants to know if it's worth watching or not by looking at the ratio between likes and dislikes. And so, inspired by Tom Scott's video that writes the amount of current views in the title, I decided to do something similar but for likes and dislikes. I started by trying to do that using the Google Apps script in combination with the YouTube API documentation. But guess what? Even though it would appear that using certain Google APIs inside the apps scripting is super easy and the apps script language is listed second in the documentation, there are no other references whatsoever as to how to use it inside the damn documentation. So after wasting a whole day trying to understand how this programming language works and how I'm supposed to use the documentation with it, I decided to try my luck with Python the next day. So the next day, I started looking up some tutorials on how to get started with a YouTube API in Python. And I gotta say, it didn't go smoothly. It took me hours to get to the same point I was at previously in the apps script. Well, almost. Because if you're not using the apps script thing, then when you're trying to connect to the YouTube API, you need to confirm your account. And in the tutorials I've watched, people would simply accept the connection to their accounts and be done with it. But for me, I would get this confirmation code thingy given to me, saying I should plug it back into the application I am using. But I wasn't using an application. I was simply running a script in Python using the terminal. But after a couple more hours of debugging, I noticed that in actuality, all I had to do was paste the key I got back into the terminal where it tells me to paste it. I cannot believe I missed that. For hours. Thankfully though, from this point on, it was smooth sailing. Until it wasn't anymore. Credit where credit is due though, the YouTube API documentation is pretty nice if you're using Python, since you can just look for a function you wish to use, and then by clicking on the Try This API panel, you can populate the functions with inputs and then literally copy-paste working code into your project. So the reason the sailing stopped being smooth at one point is because I worked quite a bit on retrieving all the pinned comments of my videos in order to display the dislike counter inside of them, only to find out that once you edit a pinned comment using the YouTube API, it unpins itself. And that's a problem, because then people won't be able to easily see the metrics of the video. So yeah, if you're going to program things from the top to the bottom, first make sure your bottom step actually works. But I solved the common problem by just displaying the metrics at the top of my description, which is actually better for desktop users since it's very close to where the actual like and dislike buttons are, but it's horrible for mobile users since the description is not partially visible on phones and people rarely open up the description of a video. In any case, soon after I started working on the description, I was done with all the code. Here's the intense moment where I ran the code on all my videos, hoping a bug wouldn't yeet the channel into outer space.
Let's hope for the best. And it's done. So now... Nice. And just to prove that that's the case, here it is, and it has 11 dislikes.
And that's the story of how the YouTube API and my code met and produced this bastard of a dislike counter. Now, I've read somewhere that on the 12th of December, YouTube might disable the retrieval of dislike information through the official YouTube API, so in a week or so, all of this might stop working. But Even so, it was a fun little project, and if that really happens, I might look into an alternative of extracting the dislike data, since it's still going to be visible to me in my YouTube Studio thing where I have all my analytics. With that said, feel free to join my Discord channel in the description below, and a huge thank you to all my supporters on Patreon, especially to Kyle Vondra, who gave me the idea to make a Patreon account and has been supporting me on there for half a year already. Okay, this is the end of the video.